Hey guys, and thanks for tuning in to part 4 of the series, How to Make a Game Like Valorant. Last time we covered how to have your character equip a weapon, and then how to give that weapon an FPS feel. In this video, we're going to cover semi-automatic and potentially automatic raycast firing, and then we'll add some visual elements like a muzzle flash to the weapon. As usual, if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, and then subscribe if you want to follow along my game dev journey. If you're interested in growing the community or talking with me, come join my Discord and be part of the founding group. Also, I'm starting to get more into streaming every week, so come check me out on Twitch or even here on YouTube. The link for all those are in the description below. So on to the video. Now that we have a gun, we need to learn how to use it, right? There are multiple ways to implement shooting in games, but I think for our purpose, the best bet would be raycast shooting. Essentially, instead of firing a projectile object that collides with the target, the player just shoots a ray out of the front of him and it instantly hits the target. No more questions, alright? It just fits here. So, before we really start, I'm gonna have to get rid of this little problem that we have with the off-screen gun just ghosting around the level. It's a really easy fix that we should have done before, but there's no better time than now. All we have to do is unparent the off-screen gun from the player and voila, separate objects and it doesn't have any of that maniacal moving. One more thing I'm noticing is how we see our player and our other gun when we look down. Pretty distracting, kind of removes the nice vibes of the game. So another easy fix, we just have to do a similar thing that we did with the weapon mask on the camera. First, pop the player into a separate player layer. Don't forget his gun too. And then don't display those on the main camera. On to the raycast. To start, let's add a C# script and call it shoot. We'll open that up and when it opens, we'll clear it out. Start fresh. So first things first, let's add a public transform and call it firepoint. Then in update, if input.getMouseButtonDown 0, which is left click. So if we left click, we're gonna shoot the gun. Pretty simple. Now let's make a shoot gun function, which will be the raycast. When we use raycast, we have to create a raycast hit variable and we'll call it hit info. This will house all the info about the object we hit. Then we'll create a variable for our ray called ray. And we'll set equal to camera.main.screenpointArray and input.mousePosition. So wherever our mouse is pointed, that'll be the direction of the ray. Next, we'll check to see if we hit something. So if physics.raycast ray, comma, out, hit info, comma, and then some distance. I'm gonna do 40 here. Probably should be more like 400, but for now it's okay. And so if that's true, we'll call it debug.log on whatever we hit, which will be hitinfo.collider.name. Also, looking back at it, I don't think we need the firepoint here, so let's just delete that. And that should be good. Let's test this out. Pop the shoot script on the player, create a cube, we'll call it enemy, stretch it out, make it a little taller. Let's duplicate it a couple times, and now let's shoot him. Boom, boom, we got it. If you look at the console, you can see we're actually shooting him, and there we go, we even hit the ground. Next, we have to add the graphics so it really looks like we're shooting, and just to stay super duper organized, we'll create another script and we'll call it shoot.gfx. This is gonna house and spawn all our graphics. It's good for beginners to practice segmenting and segregating your code. The first thing I'll add is a public game object and we'll call it muzzle flash. Then a public transform, we'll call it firepoint. And in update, we'll call input.getMouseButtonDown 0, the same as before. And we'll instantiate the muzzle flash at the firepoint position and give it no rotation, so quaternion.identity. So now we need to find ourselves a muzzle flash. I use the WarFX bundle on the Unity Asset Store. It's my favorite price, free. So check that out. And now I'll search muzzle flash down in the folder. I found the best one was the four planes rifle one. So we'll take that and we'll save that as our own prefab, and I'm just gonna call it muzzle flash so we can find it easier. And let's pop that shoot GFX script onto the player. Okay, and now let's create a firepoint for our off-screen M16. So when we fire, we can actually see the muzzle flash. Okay, and now that we have the firepoint, let's drag the firepoint onto the script. Then we go to prefabs and we'll drag the muzzle flash and put that on there. Let's test it out. And boom, can't see it. Another easy fix. We just have to put our muzzle flash on the correct layer, which in this case would be weapon. So we'll actually rename this muzzle flash off screen, and now we're gonna resave it as a prefab. Let's drag the new muzzle flash onto the script. And now when we fire, at least it's something. So I have two issues with this, but we'll work on one at a time. First and foremost, we only want the muzzle flash to last an instant. Let's create a helper script and call it destroyed game object. Basically, we can take this script and put it on any object we want to destroy over time. It's one of the most useful helper scripts I've learned, which was from Awesome Tuts. This channel is also great. So let's open the new script, clear it out, and add start, and then a new function, which is called destroy this object, which does destroy this.gameObject. And then in the start function, just invoke or destroy this object function, and we'll give it a time to destroy, which will create as a public float and default it to 2. Now let's go back to our muzzle flash, add the new script. Let's change the time to 0.2, which is just a flash. All right, test looks good. It's destroying. Now to rotate. It looks like we need about 90 degrees. So first, let's make a private quaternion and call it spawn angle. We'll go to start and set that equal to quaternion.euler. Now, we need a vector 3, so we'll create a public one. We'll call it angle. And let's pop angle in the spawn angle. All right. And also, let's set it equal to 0, 90, 0. And with that testing, it's backwards. Sometimes just everything goes wrong. You just have to change the value from 90 to negative 90. Simple. Now let's add our second muzzle flash. Just copy paste the game object in the transform, and I'm going to rename them. Muzzle flash player and firepoint player. Now let's expand the if statement. Copy our instantiate and just change the values of muzzle flash and firepoint. Back in Unity, let's rename the off-screen firepoint, and in the editor, let's populate the script. And actually, I think we only need one muzzle flash, so let's delete one of them and just call the other one muzzle flash. In the instantiate, change them both to match. Let's populate the script, and on testing, bing, bang, boom, it works. But alas, we have another problem. Our player's firepoint is on his chest. Let's just make that a child of the gun and move it into position. Easy. So now we're going to add automatic shooting. So first let's add a bool called automatic, then an update, if automatic, then if input mouse button 0, which is not mouse button down. It's if we hold down the left click. Now if our timer is greater than our fire rate, which is 2 more variables we have to make, then we'll shoot the gun. Pretty simple. Now we'll add an else, and we'll just pop in the normal fire script there, so either we're automatic or not. Now let's make a public float, and we'll call it timer, and another called fire rate. Let's set fire rate equal to, how about, 0.2f, which is like 300 rounds per minute. Sounds like an automatic gun could fire that much. Make sure when you nest these if statements that you have the order right, otherwise you'll have some odd glitches. First, let's have the timer plus equals time.delta time, which will start the count. And every time we shoot, the timer will be set back to 0. And so now every 0.2 seconds, we should fire the gun. Now before we move on, I'm going to move the timer to only count while we hold the button. Alright, now on to testing. Let's check the automatic box and... what do you know it? Something else is going on. And it's actually because of the shoot graphics script. Instead of spawning the muzzle flash on click, we want to spawn it whenever we use the shoot gun function. So in the shoot graphics script, we'll create a function called shoot gun, which just instantiates the 2 muzzle flashes, and then we'll just spawn those from our shoot function. In order to do that, we're going to turn the shoot graphics script into a singleton. Basically, at the top of the script, create a public static shoot graphics variable, and we'll call it instance. Then, in the awake function, let's set instance equals to this. And so now back in shoot, create a private shoot graphics variable, and we'll call it underscore shoot graphics. In start, we'll set shoot graphics equal to shoot graphics.instance. And now at the top of the shoot gun function is where we'll call shoot graphics.shoot gun. And now, every time we shoot, the gun graphics should spawn. Boom, 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 boom. There we go. Shooting automatically. Now, before we finish, I'm going to change one thing. When we're not holding the button, it should count back to 0.2 and stop, making it ready to fire. In order to do that, inside of automatic, but outside of the mouse button statement, we'll say, if timer is less than the fire rate, then timer plus equals time.delta time, which will keep the timer ready for the next shot. And that's all for this video. In the next one, we'll focus on adding sound effects and potentially a little health system into the game. Thanks for watching the video. If it provides you any value, make sure to like it, and don't forget to subscribe to follow along on my game dev journey. Feel free to leave any questions, comments, or concerns, or whatever kind of content you want to see here in the future. Thanks. Bye.